अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास, हाउ आर यू ऑल ऑफ यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड ऑल माई स्टूडेंट्स हैव एंजॉयड देयर वेकेशंस वेरी वेल. सो स्टूडेंट्स, इज द टाइम फॉर लर्निंग नाउ एंड वी हैव टू स्टार्ट आर चैप्टर पाकिस्तान. सो स्टूडेंट्स, कैन यू टेल मी इन विच कंट्री डू यू? ओह यस, वी लिव इन पाकिस्तान. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, वी विल लर्न टुडे अबाउट द पाकिस्तान एंड विच थिंग्स वी विल लर्न टुडे अबाउट पाकिस्तान. How many provinces are there and what kind of capitals they have and which is our national capital and what kind of things are in Pakistan. So the table of contents would be the reading of chapter number 4. As you all know, we are used to do reading first and then we were used to do the decoys, and after that we will complete our workbook work. And today we will complete the page number 23, 24 and 25. After that we will learn all the work to get the best understanding. Okay students, let's start our chapter Pakistan. You know, all of you know very well, the name of our country is Pakistan and its full name is Islamic Republic of Pakistan. Islamic Republic of Pakistan means a country which is under the control of Islamic rulers and Islamic rules. It is situated. Situated means located. It is located or situated in the largest continent of the world, Asia. You know that we have 7 continents, and where is Pakistan located? It is located in the Asia. After that, we will move towards our neighboring countries. You all know the meaning of neighboring? Yes, the near one to our country. And we will learn about how many countries are near to our Pakistan. So let's see this compass. There are east, look at here, east, north, west and south. Okay, in the east, which country is there in the east? There is India. India is in the east. Which country is in the west? There is Iran. I have highlighted, you can also highlight it. In the west, there is Iran. In the northwest, there is Afghanistan. And in the northeast, there is China. And in the south, there is Arabian Sea. Let's revise it again. In the east, India. In the west, there is Iran. In the northwest, there is Afghanistan. In the northeast, there is China. And in the south, there is Arabian Sea. I hope you all have understand it, and let's move towards our provinces. Okay, who will tell me that he has read or listened or visited the provinces? Okay, so you cannot tell me, I know, but you can think it in your mind. Okay, provinces. There are 4 provinces named as Punjab, Sindh, Balochistan and Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, and they have their own capital cities. The major cities is known as capital city, and which has so many facilities. And students, you know that there are 4 provinces but 2 self-governing territories. They are called Gilgit-Baltistan and Azad Kashmir. Self means self-governing territories means they run their system by themselves. And they are not yet announced as a provinces, and they will soon announce, but yet not announced. And officially they are not as counted as a provinces, so they run themselves by themselves. And self-governing territories are 2. Which are the 2 self-governing territories? Gilgit-Baltistan and Azad Kashmir. Okay students, let's move towards the provinces. Punjab. What is the capital city of Punjab? It's Lahore. Yes. And where do you live? Most of you people live in Lahore, and many of your friends and cousins and other people live in the other countries, in the other provinces. And Sindh has the capital city Karachi, Balochistan has Quetta, and Khyber Pakhtunkhwa Peshawar. Okay students, can you recall now the capital city of Punjab? Yes, it's Lahore. Okay student, the next province name is Sindh. Sindh is to the north, south and east west of Pakistan. It is the location of Sindh. Sindh is the flat land and some parts are white desert. Desert means Sahara, where there is a lack of water. You know that there is not so much plants. There are so not so much greenery. So these are called deserts. Okay, you know that a major river flows from the Sindh. That name is Indus River. Okay, students, you can highlight it very well. I have also highlighted the Indus River passes through almost the middle of the province. There is a fertile plain around the Indus River. Okay, we have read that there is desert, but there is a fertile land around the Indus River because there is water. So that place would be fertile, and fertile means best to grow for the plants. All kinds of crops are cultivated here. Cultivated means grow. There are many farms in the Sindh. These cities have factories and heavy industry. Okay, students, let's recall which river flows from the Sindh. So, yes. Okay, students, now let's move ahead towards the Balochistan. There are many farms in the Sindh. These cities have factories and heavy industries. Okay, students, let's recall which river flows from the Sindh. So, yes, it's Indus River. Balochistan is situated in the southwest of Pakistan. Where is the location? Southwest. It is Pakistan's largest province. How? It is Pakistan's largest province. Have you listened? It is largest only by area. You all have to remember it. It is largest only by area. Balochistan's population is very small due to the mountainous land and lack of water. There are so many mountains and there is lack of water, so there is less population. Less population means less number of people. This province is rich in the mineral resources and natural gas. Which are the two resources are found in the Balochistan? I have told mineral resources and natural gas. Yes, the capital of Balochistan is Quetta. The Quetta Valley is fertile and rich in fruit farming. Okay, you can you tell me that which is the province where has mineral and natural gas resources? Yes, it's Balochistan. And what is the capital city of Balochistan? Yes, it's Quetta. Okay, students, let's move ahead towards the next province, that is Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. Khyber Pakhtunkhwa is situated in the northwest of the country. Mountains and forest cover much of the province. Where it is situated? Northwest. And what are found there? Mountains and forest. It is the smallest province of Pakistan by area. So students, you have to remember one thing. Which was the smallest province by population? That was the previous one, Balochistan. And now we are reading about the area. Smallest province by area is Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. And can you recall here which was the largest province of Pakistan by area? Yes, it was Balochistan. Balochistan is opposite to the Khyber Pakhtunkhwa in terms of, you can say, area. Because area wise Khyber Pakhtunkhwa is small and Balochistan is area wise largest. Mining is the major industry of province, and the famous Khyber Pass links to the province of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa to the Afghanistan. Means to say that it is a way, it is the passage that links to the Khyber Pakhtunkhwa and Afghanistan. The name of the passage, the link is Khyber Pass. Okay, students, let's move towards the fourth province of Pakistan, that is Punjab. Punjab is mostly plain, covering the eastern part of the country. Some areas in the north are hilly plateaus, and we all have learned about the plateaus. What are plateaus? Some areas are plain and some are highly above the land. They are not equal, and some places are above the land, higher, some are lower, some are higher and then lower, some are higher, like this. This is the largest populated province of Pakistan. Okay, we have learned the largest province by area. What was that? Yes, it was Balochistan. Now we are learning about the largest populated province, that is Punjab. Punjab is the pun means you can guess it. Punjab. You move, just look at your hand. How many fingers you have? You have 5 fingers. And what we say 5 in Urdu? 5. Punjab means 5 rivers, land of 5 rivers. Punjab is called the land of 5 rivers. Punjab kisko kehte hain? 5 daryaon ki sarzameen. The soil of Punjab is very fertile. You can highlight the word fertile. That is the best soil to grow plants and other things like this. And all sorts of crops are cultivated in Punjab. Punjab has established industries, especially in textile and dairy products. It is the only province that touches every other province, and the national capital city is Islamabad. Okay, students, can you tell me the name of the largest populated province? Yes, that is Punjab. And what is the name of your national capital city? Where do you live? The national capital city. National means Qaumi. It means to say that it is not about the one province, second province, third province. It is of Pakistan and its name is Islamabad. Okay. Can you recall again? What is the national capital city of Pakistan? Yes, it's Islamabad. Okay, students, you can look at here the cursor, the arrow. Look at this arrow. This is the Punjab. What is this all? Can you guess it? What is this thing made? Yes, it's map of Pakistan. How you can guess the map of Pakistan? Yes, because there are written the 4 provinces. Look at here. This is Punjab, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, Balochistan, and Sindh. And you all have read about the capital of Punjab. Yeah, that is Lahore, and that is denoted by this symbol, black dot. Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, Peshawar, and Quetta is of Balochistan. Look at here. Here it is located. The dot is showing the symbol. Dot is a symbol of the location. And Sindh, which is the capital city of Sindh? Can you guess? Can you look at here? Yes, it's Karachi. And India. India is in the east. You all have read it. And Afghanistan is here. China is here. Iran and Arabian Sea. So, this was the... And one thing is left, students. What is the national... Where is the national capital city of Pakistan located? Can you guess? Yes, it's here. Islamabad. And let's move ahead now. And we have read that Punjab is a land of 5 rivers. And what are the names of that rivers? Indus, Ravi, Satluj, Chenab, and Jhelum. Again read it. Indus, Ravi, Satluj, Chenab, and Jhelum. Indus, Ravi, Satluj, Chenab, and Jhelum. You all have to revise and recall it again. Recall it again and again to learn and memorize. Okay, students. Which map is this? Yes, this map is showing the land of 5 rivers. Yes. How? Can you guess where are the rivers? Yes. Look at here. These lines are showing the boundaries of the rivers. These lines are not made without any purpose. These have very important purpose, and these are showing the boundaries of the rivers Satluj and then Ravi. Here is a boundary, and then Chenab, and then there is the boundary, and Jhelum. And students, look at here. Here is the Indus located. This is the boundary of Indus River. You cannot locate or write the Ravi in the place of Indus and Indus in the place of Ravi. Why? Because they have specific position in Pakistan, and that position, that location is shown by using this map. So we can never change the location. You have to memorize and recall it again and again, and this will be very helpful in your life and in your all the study career also, and professional and practical life also. So students, we have revised it, and side by side I can ask questions from you. Students, can you tell me how many provinces we have? Yes, we have 4 provinces, and Now it's the time of dick words. Students, these are 10 dick words. Islamic Republic of Pakistan, continent, Afghanistan, Arabian Sea, Gilgit, Baltistan, Azad Kashmir, Balochistan, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, Quetta, and Satluj. Students, these are the difficult words. You have to write it on your notebook by marking date and day and write it in the neat and clean way. Okay, students, after that, you all have to complete the workbook exercise. Workbook. In the first part of the workbook, you all have to read what is written here. My interpretation. My interpretation means my self-perception. My report on my country. My interpretation means you have to write your analysis, your views, your perception details. Like if there is question written, capital city, what is written in the question? Look again, here is written Pakistan. So you will not write the name of the any province capital. You will write the capital city of Pakistan. What is the capital city of Pakistan? Yes, it's Islamabad. And the languages of Pakistan, you will not write the one language, okay, remember it, because it's the question about Pakistan. Languages: Urdu, Punjabi, Pashto, Sindhi, Balochi. Prime Minister: who is the Prime Minister of Pakistan? Yes, it's Imran Khan. And what is the currency we use? You all use it, and you have also gained it on Eid as Eid, rupee. It's rupee. Okay. Draw the country's flag in the box below. So here it is drawn, the flag, and you all know two colors of flag and one moon and star. The white part is showing the minorities and green part is showing the majority. Okay, students, let's move ahead. Famous people: Abdul Sattar Eidi. You all know that who was he? Work hard. He introduced the ambulance system, and he worked hard for the poor people and the needy and all those who were injured. And Abdul Sattar Eidi is very famous, and he is so great person. And you know that now Abdul Sattar Eidi ambulance is the most famous, and it has the largest number in Pakistan, and it has a lot of services in so many cities of Pakistan. And students, the next name is Dr. Abdul Qadir Khan. You all know Dr. Abdul Qadir Khan has major role in making our country as atomic power country. He contributed his energy, his talent to make our country prosper and long living. So we are thankful to Abdul Sattar Eidi and Dr. Abdul Qadir Khan. And we are also thankful to Shahid Khan Afridi. He is also very famous. Who is that person? Can you guess? Yes, he is a all-rounder, cricketer and bowler. And he is a famous personality of Pakistan, and he is also doing so much social services for the people of Pakistan. And which foods we eat? Yes, is daleem and harissa, halwa puri, biryani, sajji. Which is your favorite? Yes, it's biryani. Okay, let's move ahead. Okay, students, this is the exercise. Question number one, choose the correct answer. The soil of the Dash province is very fertile. Yes, it's Punjab. Okay, the next is, Dash is the smallest province of Pakistan by area. Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. Balochistan is rich in Dash resources. Dash province has flatland, and that is Sindh. Yes, Pakistan is situated in the largest continent of the world, that is Asia. Okay, match the columns. Now, you all have to write it very carefully and not to do any messy work. Okay, mark the numbering here as 1, 2, 3, 4 we have marked here. You can use the colored pencils to match Iran. What is the Pakistan shared the borders with Dash. You have to mark with it in front of the countries, in front of these countries, their borders. Okay, Iran. Where it is located? In the west. Afghanistan. Can you guess? Yes, it is in the northwest. China. China is in the northeast. India. India is in the east. Arabian Sea. It is in the south. Okay, students, let's move towards the question number 3. Use an atlas to find the capital city of these countries. Saudi Arabia. What is the national capital city of Saudi Arabia? It is Riyadh. Afghanistan, Kabul. Iran, Tehran. India, New Delhi. China, Beijing. Okay, students, next is the true false. And you all have to write in the brackets true and false. And if the statement is true, then you have to write it as it is. And if it is false, you have to correct it. Okay, the first one is, in the west of Pakistan, there is China. So is it right? In the west, west is Iran. So correct it. In the sink, there is the desert around the Indus River. It is right or wrong? So you all have to understand, in near the Indus River, that there was not desert, there was the fertile plain. So it's false. You have to write it F and you have to correct it. Balochistan is the Pakistan's largest province by population. So recall it once again. Balochistan was the largest province by area, not by population. So correct it. Mining is the major industry of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. Is it right? Yes. Punjab is the only province that touches every other province. So yes, it's also right. And name the two self-governing territories of Pakistan, Gilgit-Baltistan and Azad Kashmir. So bitte, your writing should be very neat and clean, and you have to learn the spellings as well. Name the five rivers of Pakistan. Yes, Indus River, Ravi, Satluj, Chenab and Jhelum. Okay students, this was the all work we have to do today. And I hope that you all have understand it. If you have any question, you can ask me. And thanks for being here. And please subscribe to this channel and stay tuned and stay happy. Have happy time ahead. Allah Hafiz.